Hello, my name is Metodi Mladenu, and I will introduce you our work with my colleague Paska Janeva on theme utilization of the energy potential of waste new and creating a green workplace. I hope you will like it, and if you have some questions, we will talk after that. Now, the issue of funding a suitable eco-technological approach for the utilization of waste meal generated in the production of vegetable oil is extremely relevant in terms of achieving a high non-waste degree in modern oil production. In practice, the direction related to the application of the milk as a material resource in animal husbandry is widely known. At the same time, there are alternative areas related to other economic sectors such as composting, biodiesel production, heat treatment, and so on. The creation of green jobs, which directly or indirectly contribute significantly to the protection and restoration of the environment and to the reduction of the consumption of energy and raw materials, is extremely relevant in this direction. The main purpose of our work is to conduct an objective and science-based review based on available techniques and technology to determine the future direction for the utilization of the energy potential of waste meal, along with the assessment of the possibility of creating a green workplace. This is such a new direction of working. Our motivation was that in world, olive oil production is concentrated in the Mediterranean region, and olive oil production is one of the major sectors of agriculture whose growth is expected to continue in the future. This industry generates significant amount of waste and byproducts during the olive oil processing. The type of the waste is a serious environmental problem for such country which produces olive oil, and mainly because emerging soil and water pollution. The use of generated meal as a raw material or energy resource will help to achieve a positive economic effect for processing enterprises in two directions. First is that reducing the price of produced olive oil, and the second is reducing the cost of treatment of the generated waste meal. Balancing economic growth and the need to protect the environment are challenging goals to increase energy efficiency and to promote renewable energy as well to reduce the waste. According to the International Labour Organization, about 2 million people die each year as a result of work-related accidents and occupational illnesses. Here you can see some statistics, which is from European Union. Here we are shown the shame of production of olives and olive oil and the possibly dangerous for the workers who work in this sector. You can see the diagram is shown that we have two stages of process. The first stage, this is things which are conducted with the production of olives. The second stage, this is production of olive oil. You can see the possible risk in the right. You can see the possible risk for the workers, and you can see the main of this risk are risk of injuries, musculoskeletal disorders, hazards associated with machinery and equipment, which can see in the first and the second stage, danger of reptiles, bites, insects, allergic reactions, and so on. In the second stage, you can see also musculoskeletal disorders, exposure of physical hazards, exposure to biological agents, and hazards associated with machinery and equipment. When you want to use materials like a fuel, you can take in account only some of the elements which are mainly for this calculation process. Here, these elements are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, ash, total ash, and moisture content in this material. In our case, this is waste meal of olive oil production. You can see the formula shown that the sum of that elements must be 100%. We are used one formula which are proposed from the colleague Jolevich. According to him, this formula is give very good accuracy of the calculation. Also, based on the values obtained for the heat of combustion of the test materials, which gives 1 kilowatt per hour, burning of 1 kilowatt per hour is equal to 3.5 megajoules, it's easy to calculate the energy value that will generate during the complete combustion of 1 kilogram and respectively 1 ton from the material. Also, we done calculation for saved energy for parts for household on the basis of average family of 4, which consuming 315 kilowatt per hour energy per month. Pardon, per month. Now here we are give the life cycle assessment of olive oil production process. You can see the main, maybe the most important here is that the main waste which are generated here, that is technological residues at transport and logistics, and packaging waste, such as bottles, containers, and so on. You can see also the direction of utilization of olive meal, food for animals, production of compost, biodiversification, production of electricity. Of course, it has many and other, but this is the main. Here we are showing the our results from done calculation of the process. You can see thermal properties. In the first table, this is the oxygen which is required for combustion, and also the needed excess air for combustion process. In the second table, this is the results of calculation of the excess air required for combustion process. Also, you can see these waste gases which can be separated from the process. Here we are show the results of heating value. Also, again, here with these results are on base of calculation. Here is the heating value in electricity of combustion of 3 tons, economic electricity from conventional sources for 10 households per month. You can see the olive meal in the final here. You can see the olive meal which we fetch 6% of moisture that can have the most economized electricity for 15 months. And the conclusions of our work, the results of the calculation show that the use of waste meal for energy production is not only possible, but also economically justified in order to save energy from fossil fuels. It is recommended that the combustion of the meal must be carried out in specialized combustion plants in combination with combustible materials with low humidity and equipped with specialized equipment for capturing and cleaning the generated waste gas. The description of the production process and the identified hazards for their workers show that the green, from an ecological point of view, manufacturers not always safe for the workers. Now, thank you for your attention, and I will introduce you my concepts. I will hope to send me one question if you have to me. Thank you very much.